Barrio. This boxer is 30 years of age, a professional record of 30 fights, 11 wins, 19 losses. Don't be fooled, he's met some of the best competition in South America. 4 wins by knockout at 75.65 kilograms. Would you welcome to Melbourne for the first time, Fernando Marcos Gonzalez. And across the ring in the blue corner, aiming for an International Boxing Federation World Youth Championship. He brings to center ring tonight a perfect record. 7 fights, 7 wins, 6 by knockout. With Arif Kattel, Danny Kaye, Paul Tawil and Craig Dunn in the corner. At 75.70 kilograms, 22 years young, reigning Victorian super middleweight champion. The familiar black trunks, would you welcome Zach Dynamo Dunn. Here's Tony Moretta.
Well, here we are, Frank Ropus, main event of the evening. Zach Dunn, of course, the Victorian super middleweight champion. Up against Fernando Gonzalez from Argentina. Looks like Murray Thompson's got onto the Argentinian fighters. Well credentialed, well schooled. He's got 30 fights under his belt, does Fernando Gonzalez. 11 wins, 19 losses. Be very, very good for Zach Dunn tonight.
Well, I'm tipping he's a very crafty character.
Gonzalez in the long, light blue shorts. And Zach in his
beautiful left hook.
Familiar black trunks.
Zach. Ooh. Beautiful right hand. Overarm right hand. Boy, Zach. Hit the mark flush.
He's, in his last fight, he went the distance with another Argentinian. He seems to have more intent tonight, Frank.
Yeah, he has.
Interesting with Gonzalez, in his last 12 fights, he's won 9, Frank. So
that's incredible.
His record seems lopsided.
But Zach's doing the smart thing now. He's putting on pressure. He's putting on pressure. He's not letting Fernando get balanced. Keeping the pressure on, he's doing it. He's pacing himself.
I think this is what he didn't do in his last fight. When we did go the distance against Mourinho Riva, he's won 2 punches, step back.
Yeah, they're beautiful. He's a beautiful body puncher. He's a brilliant body puncher, Zach. And that's what he's got to do. Go to the body, kill the body and the head will die. And that's how you fight these Argentinian guys, mate. They're too crafty. They'll make you miss all night. But if you start hitting them in the body, that gives them something to think about. That's good man, Zach, good man. Those body punches.
Ripping lefts and rights of the body.
That's good.
Oh, nice.
And I love that overarm right of his. Gets over the guard. It's a beautiful punch. I must work on that in the gym.
Yeah, those body punches have got to be telling already.
Well, that's what he didn't do his last fight. He headhunted. And now he's going to the head and the body.
Well, that's, if you look at the last two fights, this fight and his last one against Riva, that's his best round, Frank, I think. That's his, that's a terrific round.
Yeah.
Gonzalez last fought in April and won by a KO in the first, and he's not known as a power puncher. Most of his wins have come by decision. He's had four KOs.
He's a little bit soft in the stomach, mate. I don't think he's going to be able to, you know, if it was, if Zach just went out hitting him to the head all night, Fernando would go the distance. But he won't go the distance if he keeps them body punches up. That's for sure.
If you remember Reaver in his last fight, he had the same thing. He carried a little bit of weight too, didn't he?
He didn't go to the body that fight. He is now. And that's what you got to do with these Argentinians, mate. Because they're crafty characters, crafty boxers. They've got a lot of ring craft about them. Even if they haven't, they might have great records, but he's been in with a few good opponents. He knows his way around the ring, that, there's no doubt about that. Gonzalez.
Zach's a better defensive fighter than perhaps I thought he was too. Just looking at him now, he's slipping punches.
Oh, those body
his gloves
punches
are up quick. This is a different fighter to the last one we saw.
Yeah.
He's throwing punches. So he's good. Good punches the body.
He's going to the body. That's the main thing.
He's hurt. I think Gonzalez is hurt.
He doesn't like those body punches.
Just a quick punch if, after the break.
If Zach hadn't gone to the body, Fernando
wicked body punch, left hand to the body. I think it's all over, Frank. It's all over. That's all over. Good night. That was an unbelievable left hand to the body, probably one of 25 that he'd thrown in a round and a half. He's crook,
and that's what he didn't do his last fight.
He came out with more intent, didn't he?
Yeah.
Look, he has power in both hands, doesn't he? And the thing I like about him is he's a better defensive fighter than he was three or four fights ago. But he's just come out to stamp himself in this fight, has done it, and he's got another KO.
He's a world-class fighter on the way, potential. There's no doubt about that.
Well, Howard Leeson, in his introduction, suggested the IBF are looking at him for a world junior title fight, a youth title fight. So Zach's record goes to 8 wins and 7 KOs. And he's got to be on an Australian title fight calculations at some point, doesn't he?
He's more than worthy of an Australian title.
The time was 1 minute 51 seconds into round 2. Your winner by knockout to take his record to 8 fights, 8 wins, 7 by knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, Zach Dynamo Dunn. And a big round of applause for a fearless man who took a lot of punishment, Fernando Marcos Gonzalez. How about 3 cheers for Zach? Hip hip. Hip hip. Hip hip. Zach, your punching power went up 100 notches tonight. You've been working on your body hooks and your right cross over the top. Well done. Congratulations.
Yeah, you know, like last fight was the first time I went 8 rounds. You know, now I know I can go 8 rounds. And tonight, you know, I just picked it up, picked the pace up, I know I can go that 8 rounds. So, yeah, I knocked him out. It's good. But, yeah, I'd like to thank Malcolm, my sponsor, down there. I'd like to thank my corner man, Arab Cartel, Paul Tawau, and my trainer, Danny Kay. And thanks to all my family and friends that came to support me tonight. Thanks.
Well done, Zach. A brilliant performance tonight. Winner by knockout inside 2 rounds. On behalf of Murray Thompson and our commentary team, David Griffith, Frank Rampus, our ringside physician, Dr. Harris, members of the Professional Boxing Combat Sports Board, timekeeper Damien Memory, Howard Lee saying, protect yourself at all times, both physically and emotionally. Reach for the stars and keep punching, Wayne. Thank you, staff, for a great night at the Hungarian Stadium. 15-year celebration of Murray's first show. On behalf of Fighters Factory, good night. Thank you.
Catch lightning in the bottle.